Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel English Tutorial. Today we will discuss about Percy vs. Shelley's idealism. I am Rajni Meena, Assistant Professor, Government College, Rawalpindi. Shelley's idealism. Shelley's unconventional life and uncompromising idealism, combined with his strong disapproving voice, made him an authoritative and much denigrated figure during his life and afterward. He became an idol of the next two or three or even four generations of poets, including the important Victorian and pre-Raphaelite poets, Robert Browning, Alfred Tennyson, Dante, Gabriel Rossetti, and Algernon, Charles Swinburne, as well as Lord Byron, Henry David Thoreau, W.B. Yeats, Aleister Crowley, Edna St. Vincent Millay, and poets in other languages such as Jane Kasprowicz, Rabindranath Tagore, Jivananda Das, and Subramanyu Bharati. His thoughts about nonviolence. Henry David Thoreau's Civil Disobedience, the writings of the Leo Tolstoy and Mahatma Gandhi's Passive Resistance were all influenced and inspired by Shelley's theories of nonviolence, nonviolent resistance in protest and political action. It is known that Shelley would often quote Shelley's The Mosque of Anarchy, which has been called perhaps the first modern statement of the principle of non-violent resistance. Shelley was a vegetarian. Shelley wrote several essays on the subject of vegetarianism, and the more prominent of which were A Vindication of Natural Diet, 1813, and On the Vegetable System of Diet. Shelley's eagerness of vegetarianism is connected with India. In 1812, he was converted to vegetarianism by his friend John Frank Newton, who had himself been converted while living in India. In Queen Mab, a philosophical poem, 1813, he wrote about the change to a vegetarian diet, and he wrote, "And a man no longer now, he says, the lamb that looks him in the face and horribly devours his mangled flesh." Keats Shelley's memorial house at Wright, with a red sign by the Spanish Steps, Rome. Shelley's mainstream following did not develop until a generation after his death. Unlike Lord Byron, who was popular among all classes during his lifetime despite his radical views, for decades after his death, Shelley was mainly appreciated by only the major Victorian poets, the pre-Raphaelites, the socialist, and the labor movement. One reason for this was the extreme discomfort with Shelley's political radicalism, which led popular anthologists to confine Shelley's reputation to relatively sanitized magazine pieces such as Ozymandias or Lines to an Indian Air. He was admired by C.S. Lewis, Karl Marx, Robert Browning, Henry Stephen Salt, Gregory Corso, George Bernard Shaw, Bertrand Russell, Isadora Duncan, Constant Naden, Utopian Sinclair, Gabriel Annunzio, Aleister Crowley, and W.B. Yeats. Shelley had an enduring and profound influence on the Dutch poets of the Nieuwe Gids. Samuel Barber, Sergei रचमिनोफ, रोजर क्विटलर, होवर्ड स्केम्प्टन, जॉन बंसेलाइस एंड राल्फ वैगन विलियम्स कंपोज्ड म्यूजिक बेस्ड ऑन हिज पोएम्स. Critics such as Matthew Arnold endeavored to write Shelley's legacy to make him seem a lyricist and a dilettante who had no serious intellectual position and whose longer poets were not worthy of study. Arnold famously described Shelley as a beautiful and intellectual infectual angel. This position contrasted strongly with the judgment of the previous generation, who knew Shelley as a skeptic and a radical. Many of Shelley's work remained unpublished or little known after his death, with longer pieces such as A Philosophical View of Reform existing only in manuscript until the 1920s. This contributed to the Victorian idea of him as a minor lyricist. With the inception of formal literary studies in the early 20th century and the slow rediscovery and re-evolution of his oeuvre by scholars such as Kenneth Neil Cameron, Donald H. Raman and Harold Bloom, the modern idea of Shelley could not be more different. Paul Foote, in his Red Shelley, had documented the pivotal role Shelley's work, especially Queen Maeve, have played in the genesis of British radicalism. Although Shelley's work were banned from respectable Victorian household, his political writings were pirated by men such as Richard Carlyle, who regularly went to jail for printing sedition and blasphemous libel. And these cheap pirates' edition reached hundreds of activities and workers through the 19th century. So, this is the idealism of Shelley. Thank you so much.